on, Rins. This is my horse, Rins. We've just had a beautiful ride, and now I'm taking him back down to the barn. I have lots of animals here on the farm, and I love my animals. A lot of my friends say they'd rather come back in their next life as one of my pets than as themselves. And that's true, don't you think, Rins? It's very important to know how to take care of your pets. So today, I'd like to show you how to care for the animals in the best possible way. So now I get to speak to one of my famous friends. This is Hailey Bieber, who's married to Justin Bieber. She wants to talk to me about grooming her dog. Here she is. Hi.
Hello.
Oh, look how pretty you look.
How are you?
I'm good.
This is Oscar.
Oscar.
What's that? Oh.
There you are. Oh, look.
What's that?
Do you remember my roasting of Justin?
Yeah, of course. We were just talking about that.
We had such a nice time. That was a fun night.
Yeah, it was great. It was really fun.
So what are you doing with Oscar? Do you want to know something about dog care?
I would love to get some tips on how to give my dog the right haircut. I gave Oscar a haircut a couple weeks ago because I found a tick on him when we were in Canada. So I shaved him. But I shaved him with like the wrong shaver. I did the best I could, Martha, I swear, but he had a very jagged haircut. Oh, he looked like a little rat.
Now it's growing back in a little bit, I can see. But you know, dogs don't like to be shaved just because the hair itself acts as an insulation against the heat and also against the sunburn. So don't let him get sunburned while he doesn't have a coat.
Yeah, for sure.
Justin, did he participate in the shearing of the dog?
He tried to help a little bit, and then he just kept being like, you're just ruining the dog. You're just ruining his haircut. But it grew back nicely.
Sweet, yes. It is growing back nicely.
I tried to keep affirming him and telling him he looked really handsome so that he didn't feel bad.
So Oscar got his haircut. Have you cut Justin's hair?
He would remove one of my fingers before he let me cut his hair.
Really?
No way would he let me cut his hair.
Oh, brother.
I asked him if I could, and he was like, you're funny.
Give my love to Justin.
For sure.
And keep up taking good care of your pets.
Bye-bye. Thank you, Martha. Bye.
Ciao, ciao, Oscar.
Say bye, Oscar. Say ciao, ciao.
Bye, Oscar. And now our big chore of the week is dog washing. Ari.
Hi, how are you?
This is Ari Cast. He is raising black Labradors. He's going to be helping me out today. Ari and I met at Westminster last year when he was showing this beautiful dog. And this is Safari, who was she number one bitch
last year
at Westminster. The year before, I showed Empress Chin, my female chow, who did very well. So we've been very happy with our beautiful dog. So now you're gonna rinse. I'm gonna get ready to do the chow chows. So this is Carlos Villamil. He is my driver on the weekends. More famous for taking care of the dogs because he is like the dog whisperer.
Let's go, let's dance.
Spanish music, they love that.
He has devised a dog washing outfit out of a garbage sack. Is that for me?
Yes.
Now, I've never worn a garbage bag before. This is totally new for me. I don't think the armholes are big enough, Carlos. Here, just, I'll do that. I'm the dressmaker.
Come this way.
Also, these are scented. Why would they scent garbage bags? Ask those people. Ugh. Do you like? So, okay, let's start.
There's many rules to follow when you're bathing animals.
Don't shoot it right in their face and make sure the water is a nice, mild, warm temperature. Now you're gonna get some shampoo for dogs. So start at the neck and go down to the tail. Just make sure you really get those hindquarters nice and wet and soapy. And then rub-a-dub-dub. So very important to rinse totally. You want to get every bit. Can you stand her up?
Okay.
I need to get her stomach.
Okay.
She looks like a platypus.
Okay, Carlos, I'm done with her. Oh, there she goes. And boy, I would be totally soaked if I didn't have my garbage bag bib on. Now, blow drying. Now you sit girl. So now, when you're using a hairdryer, put your hand under the hairdryer so that you never, ever burn your dog. I groom my dogs every single day, just to check them for fleas and ticks, for knots and brambles and whatever else. A good healthy dog that should probably be groomed at least once a month.
Oh, yeah.
But be careful with a brush like this on the hindquarters or underbelly of your dog. Hindquarters are extremely tender. Be cognizant. You wouldn't want anybody brushing you.
Roughly and pulling out all of your hair.
No, that hair. Okay, we're going to stop with the blow drying.
Good girl, Jane.
I lower her myself. Let's do Safari's nails.
Yep.
Oh.
And that's how she gets in the car,
too. So great.
So the nails, they're my pet peeve. I like to keep them very, very short, and once a week.
Oh, you do?
Oh, yeah. I use this fantastic rotary Dremel that's designed for wood, but works perfectly for dogs. So this is long. You'll know when
it's great. My dogs have not had their nails done for 5 months.
Oh. 5 months?
No.
That's not good.
Ari, come here. Have you seen the donkeys lately?
No.
They're so cute. Hey, Rufus. This is Billy.
Yeah.
That's Rufus. And this is Clyde. Oh, I love these so much. Now, these are Sicilian miniatures.
Yes.
Of different sizes. But these beautiful donkeys come from a farm down in Alderson, West Virginia, where I had to spend 5 months at camp.
Yeah.
I love them. And next door are two newest, Jude and Truman,
I know.
Named after my grandchildren, and they are rescues. Now, they were skittish and sad. And just in about 4 months, they are like different, friendly animals. And look, it looks like they have nail polish on them.
I know, it's so shiny.
They're so beautiful.
Varnish.
So here's a part of the program that I really like. I find it very interesting that my producers are trying to find projects that are going to impress me. I like to do this. I like to see what people are up to. Now, I'll be impressed if I'm impressed, but I'm not gonna fake it.
Hi, I'm Lainey Kluser, and this is Rotini. We live in Woodward, Oklahoma, and we have a project that we really hope impresses Martha. This is our cat tree made out of reclaimed branches that fell down in an ice storm a couple years ago. It's got a lot of nice, really scratchy places for the cats. It's basically just the branches screwed to plywood, leveled off, and then upholstered to look like a really nice piece of furniture in our house that we like to look at and our cats like to lay on. Martha, I hope this impressed you.
I have cats, and I know how much cats love to climb and be on top of it all. Empress Tang and Princess Peony would adore such perches. That cat tree is gorgeous. I wouldn't mind having that in any room in my house. Lainey, congratulations. You've done a good thing.
Hey, guys. Everybody happy? Everybody good?
Maybe I'll sprinkle them. Should I sprinkle the goose?
Oh, with the hose?
Some of them like it and some of them don't.
If they hated it, they would be running away. Nice, gentle rain.
Martha, we've seen so many of your animals today. You have any favorites?
I have no favorites, unlike my mother. My mother had 6 children, and none of them were her favorite. None.
You love them all equally.
All creatures, great and small, on this farm are